Hi, this is Thomas Gunther. If you are a keyboard player who uses Logic Pro, like I do, this tip is sheer gold for you. How often do you have these moments where you're just noodling around and all of a sudden something awesome happens, but you didn't record? Well, Logic is always listening. Let me show you. You can clearly see it looks like nothing has been recorded. No region has been created. The score editor is empty until I press Shift R. Here it is. Just know that this only works when an instrument track is selected while you're playing your keyboard. So even if you're not in record mode, so to say, you can capture this recording. Now that's old news to some people, but here's something I just learned yesterday. It does this even when you are in standby. So you don't have to be in play or record mode at all. Logic is always listening to your keyboard, so to say. Okay, so now when we look at the score, we can see that it doesn't align with the project tempo. Obviously, Logic was in standby, so I didn't hear a click. I was just playing what I was feeling in the moment. So my quarter notes were much slower than the project tempo. Now we can easily tell Logic to fix this. Just do a right click on the region and then say, apply project tempo to region. And you're done. Check it out. So what I just did was basically tell Logic, make sure my performance works with my project tempo, and also go ahead and quantize it. Now, maybe you want to do the opposite though. Maybe you just performed a beautiful ballad and you know, it goes into some time changes and things like that. And you like those changes and you want to tell Logic, hey, use my MIDI performance as a tempo reference. And of course you can do this too. Check it out. So as you can see, Logic was paused, but it still remembers what I was playing. So all I had to do was press Shift R again, and it puts it right into my project. Now, when I look at the score editor, it looks kind of wild because all I was playing was eighth notes, but Logic cannot make heads and tails out of this. Why? Because there was no tempo reference. So my tempo doesn't agree with Logic's tempo, but we can fix this again with one command. So all we have to do is do a right click on the region, say apply region tempo to project tempo, and then just say apply. So now that Logic knows exactly the tempo and the tempo changes I played, it can do a much better job displaying the music in the score editor. In fact, it looks actually pretty darn good, don't you think?
Ooh, yeah.
All right, so I hope all these tips help you in your music production. I know it makes a hell of a difference in my music productions. It's awesome that you don't always have to press record when you just wanna get creative, you know, in the moment, and that you can capture whatever you played afterwards. And it's also awesome that Logic has all these tempo adaptive possibilities. Okay, that's it. I really hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, you might enjoy other videos I created about Logic Pro, and you find them at musictrainingonline.com. You also find some links to my other website, popjazzkeys.com, where I explain things about how to play the keyboards and jazz piano and things like that. Okay, so keep up the good work.